In this video, I'm going to show you the two new encrypt functions in the BaseElements plugin, along with demonstrating that the plugin will accept a key of any length. Let's go ahead and get started here. So this is a demo file that you can download from the article on the website or in the description of the video. So if you press the new test button here, it'll create a new test for you to test the functions, the encrypt and decrypt functions. So let's go ahead and put in the text that we want to encrypt, and then put in a key for the encryption. Let's go ahead and type ABC123 here. And then you press the encrypt button, you'll see the results of the encrypt, which look nothing like the original piece of text. In this case, the plugin is outputting a Base64 encoded version of the bits from the AES encryption method that it's using. And the reason it's Base64 encoded is it allows you to store the results in a text field. To decrypt the results here in the demo file, just press the decrypt button, and you'll see that we got back out the input that we originally started with. So that's pretty much it. The buttons here, the encrypt and decrypt, use the two corresponding functions in the plugin. So let me go and show you those. So the encrypt function here is the BE encrypt AES function. Its first argument is the key that you're going to use for encrypting, and the second argument is the piece of text that you want to encrypt. And then the decrypt button is very similar to the encrypt. The function looks very, very similar. The function in this case is the B decrypt AES function. It takes the key as the first argument, just like the encrypt function. But the second argument takes your encrypt results, not the text that you originally had encrypted. So you'll notice that the key I used was pretty short. The plugin will use a key of any length. We can use a key that's one character long. You'll see here that the encrypt results change by decrypt. It still gives me back what I started with. I can use a key of really any length. So this one's 30 characters, and I encrypt that. You'll see the results change for the encrypt. But if I decrypt, I still get back the same results. So what's going on here is the plugin AES, the AES encryption method, the plugin is using is the 256-bit encryption method, which requires a 256-bit key. But the plugin is taking what you give it as a key, and then it's MD5 hashing it, and then taking the first 256 bits of that hash, and using that as the real key instead of your key, to make sure that the plugin always works no matter what length key you give it. It's a nice user-friendly feature that we really like about the new encryption functions in the BaseElements plugin. That's it.